Hello fellow kids, welcome to another tutorial. I'm your host Weaver Beats. Today I'll be mixing vocals with Nectar 3. Let's get into it. Oh shit. Dude, is this some new video editing software? What is this? It looks sick. Shoot, ghost? Oh, okay. Yeah, that sounds cool too. Today we'll be mixing a song with vocals using Nectar 3. It's like a little interlude off my mixtape that's coming out. It's pretty simple, it's just three tracks and an instrumental.
Miss you, I love you, I miss you, I love you.
Okay, that's how it sounds before. Now I'm gonna bring in Nectar 3. Looks pretty dope. I like how it's got the assist. I'm just gonna do everything modern and moderate. Just medium. Alright, this looks like it's gonna take a minute. I'm gonna go get water and coffee. We'll be right back. Okay, so I'm digging in and looking at what it decided to do here. And I gotta say, it looks like it's making some pretty intelligent decisions. This is probably what I would try to do for the most part. I would do some EQ cutting. And I would DS, and then I would boost also, and compress. As you can see, there's a little mix knob on all of these, so you can mix in the original signal with the process signal if it's too powerful. Very good, very, very useful. I'm gonna process this other vocal separately. I think that's a good way to do it, because these two are the same. They're essentially, they're not the same take, but it's me saying the same thing twice. So it makes sense to process these two vocals differently.
Miss you. I love you. I miss you. I love you. I miss you.
Okay, let's let the auto assist do its thing here. The assistant's not gonna know what to make of this. It looks like it did a similar thing here. Okay, now that I've done some basic mixing to the beat using the vocal assistant, I am going to relay the instrumental over to the vocal, and then I'm gonna use this unmasking thing.
I miss you. I love you. I miss you. I love you. I miss you. I love you.
That sounds pretty good. I think I might start using this all the time. Maybe I can use this to work on the masking frequencies between the vocals too. I'll put another Nectar 3 on the main vocal group. With this blank Nectar 3, I'm going to use the masking source as the low vocal. And I'm going to see if I can clean it up a little more using that. Let's see, let's let it do its magic. So you can toggle the unmasking functionality on and off right here. I don't know, it's hard to see what the unmasking is doing or what changes it's making. I'm gonna redo this third vocal to include the unmasking as well. I'm gonna make sure it's set to relay, which is where I have my instrumental coming from, just like I did the other one.
I miss you. I love you. I miss you. I love you. I miss you. I love you. I miss you. I miss you.
Okay, cool. I gotta say, Nectar 3 does a really good job. Like, in basically like 5 or 10 clicks, I was able to clean up this whole mix. Although I would have to check the frequencies and whatnot to see like how in tune all this is, but it sounds pretty good to me. I mean, obviously there's a lot more I can do to this mix down, but I'm not really trying to go for like some crazy automation or anything. I'm your host Weaver Beats, and this is how you mix vocals quickly with Nectar 3. I'm gonna leave a trial for Nectar 3 down in the description if you guys wanna check it out. I highly recommend you do. Anyways, don't forget to comment, like, subscribe, check my Patreon for exclusive videos, and I'll see you guys next time. Hopefully next week.
I miss you. Miss you.